Hello, Algebra 1. Today, this is our last lesson for Chapter 4, and this is 4-7. We skipped a few. That's all right, we'll probably come back and get those later. This is going to be called inverses of linear functions. So let's just talk for a minute about what some of these words mean. First of all, inverse, this kind of means opposite. When we're talking about numbers, it means a reciprocal. Here we're talking about a function or an equation, so that's going to look a little bit differently. Linear means it makes a line. Function means that it is some sort of graph that passes the vertical line test that we talked about way back in Chapter 2, I think. I believe, or Chapter 1. I can't remember. Long time ago. So we're kind of looking at straight lines and their opposites. So that's essentially what we're talking about today. Our secret word for today is engineer. So first of all, we're going to talk about relations. And a relation, if you remember, is just a set of ordered points. And if we want the inverse of a relation, what we do is we just switch x and y coordinates. So for instance, here's a relation. I'm going to give you a relation. It's the points 4, 1, 2, negative 3, 0, negative 4, and 6, 1. And I could graph those points if I wanted to. I'm not going to do that right now. We've done a ton of graphing. We really don't need to spend a whole lot more time on that. What I'm going to do now is I'm going to write the inverse of that relation. And so what I'm going to do is I'm going to switch x and y. So 4 is x, 1 is y, so I'm going to switch those around. So the inverse is the point 1, 4, negative 32, 0, negative, or excuse me, negative 4, 0. And 1, 6. So that's the inverse. The inverse of that relation. Okay, I have a secret problem for you. First, I'm going to give you the relation. The relation is the point 1, negative 1, 0, 0, negative 8, negative 6, and 2, negative 2. And what you're going to do is you're going to write the inverse of that. All right, next we're going, that was of a relation. Now we're going to find the inverse of a function. Okay, so the inverse of a function, first of all, here's how we denote a function, f of x, or sometimes we write a cursive f, f of x. That's for the function. And then if we want the inverse, it's a little negative 1 here, like this. Or 2 matches to red. And that's the inverse. Inverse of f of x. Okay? So it's not an exponent, that just shows that it's an inverse. Okay, so there are 4 steps for finding the inverse to a function. And I'm going to tell you what those are. So for finding the inverse, first step is that you replace f of x with y. Secondly, you interchange x and y. Third, solve for y. And fourth, y with f inverse of x. All right, so I'm going to do a couple examples, and then I'm going to give you a second problem, and that's all we have to do. Okay, first of all, so here is my equation, my function. My function is that f of x equals negative 3x plus 6. So if I wanted to, I could graph that. I'm going to go ahead and do that down here. I graph the intercept first, and then I go down 3 over 1. So there's my point right there. Now I'm gonna use a different color here for the other one. And now I'm gonna find the inverse, so I'm gonna follow my steps. First of all, I replace f of x with y, so I'm gonna write y equals negative 3x plus 6. Then I interchange the x and the y. So I have x equals negative 3y plus 6. Now we like to have y on the left, so I'm just gonna flip these sides around, and I'm gonna say negative 3y plus 6 equals x. My next step is to solve for y, so I'll just and then I'm going to divide by negative 3. So that gives me y equals x over negative 3 plus 2. Now another way you could write that is just a negative 1 third x plus 2. That's the same thing. This is the same as this. Okay. Oh, whoops. Sorry about that. Right, and then our last step says replace x with y with f inverse of x. So f inverse of x equals negative 1 third x plus 2. I'm going to go ahead and sketch that graph. I go up 2, and I go down 2 over 3. Or excuse me, down 1 over 3. So there's my line right there. So the red line and the blue line are inverses of the same function. Okay, let's do another one. I'm going to erase this, and I'm going to try one more, and then give you a secret problem. First of all, my function is that f of x equals 1 half x minus 2. Let's go ahead and sketch that. I put, there's my intercept, I go up 1 over 2, so there's my line right there. I'm going to come down over here. Now I am going to find the inverse. So my first step says that I replace f of x with y. Then I interchange x and y. Then I solve for y. I like that on the other side, so I'm just going to switch sides here. So I'm going to add 2, 1 half y equals x plus 2. To get rid of 1 half, I have to multiply by 2. So on this side, I have to take the whole thing times 2. So that gives me y equals, and then I have to distribute 2x plus 4. And then my last step says replace y with f of x. Inverse. Okay, so let's graph that. Then I'm going to go up 2 over 1, and there's that line right there. That, this function right here is the inverse of this function right here. Okay, last thing is that for your secret problem, I want you to find the inverse of f of x equals 4x minus 12. So find inverse of x. Follow these four steps. You do not need to craft that one. Okay, that's all we've done for today. Thanks, guys. We'll see you. Bye-bye.